Today, I have the pleasure to talk to Stephen Snyder. And Stephen, you are the CEO of Logi Analytics, and you have a wealth of experience in embedded analytics. An interesting domain with substantial value add, but it's not so known compared to the traditional BI. Can you explain the difference between both traditional BI and embedded analytics?
Yeah, so, you know, first off, I would argue that the BI industry has permanently existed because end users couldn't get access to the information they needed out of their applications. You know, if you think about the concept of a traditional BI, it's really about becoming a centralized repository of all the data that exists within an organization. And what it does is it consolidates that information from multiple different applications so that people can go to that and look at it and make better decisions. The problem, though, is it forces end users to leave the applications they're already in to go to that different central location to get information. And as such, they lose context. They lose context of what they're working on and how they're working. It becomes less actionable. What's even worse is that the data they get in that centralized location is often not the same as what they get in the application they're already using. And that can manifest itself for a couple of reasons. It can manifest itself because the security models are different. The field names are different. The synchronization lags. So when you're looking at data in the application, it may not necessarily be the same as the data in the central repository. But all those things lead to challenges with user adoption and lead to challenges in terms of just getting the information they need when they need it so they can take action. You know, embedded analytics sets out to solve a lot of these challenges. The idea is to use the applications that people are already using to deliver information to those end users in the context of the app. And that's what we do. We partner with software teams all over the world to help their applications become more than just that system, that simple transactional system of record. And by embedding analytics, these software teams achieve a superior end-user application experience. End users are more engaged, and we're ultimately delivering on the mission that BI set out to deliver on right in the beginning, and that was to enable end users to make better business decisions.
Every software application needs an analytics component, and software teams can decide either to make or to buy. Can you elaborate on why software teams can benefit from using embedded analytics?
You know, it really comes down to what are the end user requirements of the application. You know, my point of view is that every company is becoming more like a software company and that applications are increasingly becoming more analytical in nature. And that's new. That wasn't the case 10 years ago. You know, 10 years ago, 20 years ago, most applications simply served as a transactional system of record. And that's just not okay anymore. Their applications are much more sophisticated and end users are demanding more sophistication out of their application. And that's driving a lot of the requirements for embedded analytics. Two examples I'll just kind of throw out. One, you may want to distribute information and analytics to a wider range of people in your business operations than you may have wanted to 10 years ago. Marketing is a good example of the type of functional area that has been completely transformed from one that is focused on communications, brand, collateral, trade shows, to you know, pipeline building and demand gen and thinking through how you can touch the different lever points around your marketing campaigns. And it's much more analytical in nature. The second thing is, you know, really about differentiating a software offering. So we work a lot with package software companies, companies that deliver package software. And they're always striving to deliver more value to their end users, either so that they can charge more, so that they can win more deals, or frankly, so that they can make sure the customers they already have are happy and renewing every year.
Using embedded software often depends on the effort it takes to embed, the end user experience, and the commercial model. How does your company advance embedded analytics?
Yeah, so first, we're really the only company that exclusively focuses on both software teams as our target persona and embedded analytics as our target use case. And what that means is everything that you see when you interact with us, be it from a go-to-market standpoint, from a product standpoint, or from a customer success standpoint, is really oriented around both of those things. So if you are considering a new evaluation and you work with our sales team on software, everyone they speak to is a software team looking at embedded analytics. So they probably have a better understanding of what you want to accomplish and what the pitfalls are than anybody else you're going to speak to. If you were to look at our product, you'll see that we've made some innovations around, for instance, API integration or security integration, all things that you'll want when you think about embedding analytics within an application that many other vendors wouldn't think about. And finally, when you talk to our customer success team, the last people they talked to before speaking with you had the same challenge as you do. They were software teams wanting to embed analytics within their application. And when you hang up the phone after successfully resolving the issue, the next person they're going to talk to same exact thing. So we're really good at it. Second, we just launched Logic Composer. Now, this is the first product specifically designed for software teams as a result of 7 years of R&D effort. It delivers the first out-of-the-box development experience for embedded analytics and addresses, in my view, what is the most significant gap in the market. And that gap is that in order for something in the BI space to be easy to use, you have to limit developers' control over the end-user application experience. And we've really cracked the code in solving that particular problem.
Stephen, thanks again for joining our show and sharing your embedded analytics experience. And for the audience, thank you for watching and see you next time.